Well, as I'm recording this, 15 minutes late, geez, AP. But the AP poll top 25 for November 17, 2024 has dropped for the week 12 recap. And let's take a peek and see where teams stand with just a few weeks left of the regular season. Number one, we have Oregon remaining number one after escaping Wisconsin last night. That was a lot closer than I'm sure a lot of Ducks fans wanted it to be. Right now, they're still number one, undefeated, projected to win the Big Ten. So as of right now, hold on to that top spot. We'll likely hold on to that top spot on Tuesday. But just not a Dan Lanning going for the fake field goal. And just weird things happened last night. But they got the W. Ohio State took care of Northwestern 31-7. They remain at number two. Texas remains at number three because, sure, why not? They barely beat Arkansas 20-10. That was a game in the fourth quarter. One side of the football for Texas was really good, especially their front seven. I don't know what's wrong with Quinn Ewers. I've always thought Quinn Ewers was fairly overrated, but he's the one thing you can say without question about Quinn Ewers, whether you think he's good or not. He's inconsistent. What was really worrisome, if you're a Texas fan yesterday, those short to mid-range passes he's a wizard at making or at completing, those weren't there yesterday. And there's like five or six teams out there that put up more points in Arkansas than Texas, and in a win or a loss. So I think that people are going to say, you're an Oklahoma fan, you're a hater. I'm like, you would be correct, and so just deal with it. But the truth of the matter is, you have to look yourself in the mirror and go, is this team playing its best football in mid-November when they probably should be peaking? It's one thing to lose a game early in the season, bounce back, and play better, because the defense mechanism I see is like, Tennessee lost to Arkansas. Don't tell me about things that happened in September. We're talking about things that are happening in November, and it's about you. Because when we talk about teams competing for the national title, or just teams in the SEC vying for a playoff, we're talking about teams, most of those teams, this little cluster of like five or six teams, all of them have at least one signature win. You know who doesn't have a signature win? Texas. You know where their best win is? Vanderbilt. Do not lose two games. Do not lose a game and expect to get in as a two-loss team just because. F around and find out. Don't do that. Anyway, Penn State remains at number four. They take care of Purdue, no problem, 4-9-10. Indiana remains at number five. They're on the bye week. And listen, I'm talking about Texas. I feel the same way about Indiana. Indiana might be undefeated and 10-0, but there's a reason they're not number two or number one in the country, because who have they beaten? Nobody. But unlike Texas right now, they will get their chance this coming Saturday at Ohio State. And if Indiana beats down or just actually forget, just if they just beat Ohio State, they're likely in the playoff because, okay. But right now, Indiana, it's hard to picture them doing that right now. Maybe they can, who knows? But if they just barely lose to Ohio State, maybe they get in. But man, I'll tell you what, like, there's a lot of other scenarios for other teams that are hoping for Indiana to get their doors blown off. Notre Dame moves up two spots to number six after beating down Virginia. Notre Dame's in there if you're rooting for Notre Dame to lose a game. I'm not seeing it right now, so sorry about that. Alabama, with an easy cupcake November win over Mercer, 52-7, moves up two spots to seven. Georgia will likely be back in the playoff hunt on Tuesday. They're number eight, moving up three spots after beating Tennessee by two touchdowns at home. A great homecoming for Georgia, no pun intended, but they made that happen. Was it their homecoming? It doesn't even matter. They hadn't played there in like over a month, so might as well have been. Ole Miss was off. They move up one spot to number nine. Tennessee losing on the road to Georgia. They got their second loss of the year. They're number 10. So if you're Tennessee now, you still have that win over Alabama, who's at number seven, and you just basically need to win out. If I'm Tennessee, do not lose to Vanderbilt at any cost, or you are done. The Miami Hurricanes, I believe, are off this week. They move up one spot to number 11. Boise up one spot to 12. They beat San Jose State by three touchdowns, which is good for them, for people who weren't paying attention. But they were trailing early, and it was not looking good for the Broncos. So keep an eye on that group of five spot. It's not guaranteed to go to Boise. Just stay tuned on that one. SMU moves up one spot to number 13. They had a kind of a tough game against Boston College, a little close there, but they win by 10 points at the end of the day. This is one of the bigger news stories in college football. BYU finally drops a game. Drops 7 spots after losing to Kansas. Now, this ain't your Kansas team who was like kind of good before. No, Kansas is back to being crap. They lost by 4 to Kansas, and I believe it was like a 3-point spread for Kansas initially, but flipped back to BYU. But the point of the matter is, this loss for BYU not only hurts BYU, it hurts the Big 12. Because the Big 12 no longer is guaranteed if you lived in that fantasy world of them having 2 spots. If Colorado beat undefeated BYU, that's not happening. The Big 12 just became a one-bid league. Same thing for the ACC. So, again, if you're SMU, you're undefeated in conference play, you're at the top of the ACC standings, just went out. Moving on to A&M at number 15. I believe they were off this week, so they remain at that spot. Colorado just quietly climbing up the polls. Number 16, 2 spots. Travis Hunter likely going to win the Heisman Trophy. Coach Prime, you know, proving all the haters wrong. Listen, whether you like Deion Sanders or not, you know, year 2 in Colorado, he's doing what he needs to do. He's got a chance to get his team in a spot to win the Big 12 championship and possibly in the college football playoff. Does that mean Colorado is going to make a big run? I don't know, probably not. I don't think they have the horses on the line of scrimmage to do that, but you know what? When you got this unicorn named Travis Hunter who can do it all as long as he's healthy, gives you at least a puncher's chance. Clemson at number 17, they remain there at that spot. They get away with one on the road at Pitt. Klubnik, their quarterback, gets a 50-yard keeper down the sideline and escapes Pitt. Pitt looked like they're going to steal one, and then lo and behold, there comes Dabo and the boys. Army, number 18, they dropped 2 spots, didn't play, I don't think their fault, just other things happened around them. Here's the team I'm interested in, South Carolina at 19. Okay, they're up 4 spots. We'll see where they land on Tuesday. Amazing last minute comeback against Missouri. Looked like all was lost, but with like a minute left, they were able to drive down the field and score. So the Gamecocks, 7-3, couple games left. They got like a garbage game next week, and they have a big game against Clemson. So if you're South Carolina right now, I think right now your best bet, beating Clemson in a couple weeks. You want Clemson also to win the ACC. And what else can you say about South Carolina? Let's see, who's their big win? Right now their big win is against Texas A&M. So if you live in this world where you want South Carolina to make the playoff as a 9-3 team, most of you are going to be South Carolina fans. You need to beat Clemson, but not beat them too bad because you want them healthy for the ACC title game. You want Clemson to win the ACC, and you want the Texas A&M Aggies to win the SEC. So 9-3, 2 wins, not just playoff teams, 2 teams with byes into the second round. How many teams are going to be able to say that? It's like, again, I think you need a little bit of help. You need a little bit more chaos in the SEC. Maybe, again, A&M winning the SEC, Texas would mean they would have to lose a game more than likely. You know, Tennessee maybe dropping to Vandy, who knows? Some crazy crap might happen, like Oklahoma beats Alabama. Oh, God, that hurt to say out loud. That's not happening. That is definitely not happening. We might have a shot against LSU, though. But, you know, again, LSU's not even in this poll anymore at this point. So, only double check. Yeah, LSU's dropped out. But, yeah, if you're South Carolina, you still got a shot. But, they're still, and the one other thing I'd add for the Gamecocks, our quarterback got hurt in that game we lost to LSU. That's the argument I would make for them. Oklahoma's biggest win of the year, Tulane, moves up 5 spots to number 20. Man, but all seriousness, people are overlooking Tulane to get that group of 5 spot. They whooped Navy 35-0. Whooped them. And everyone was all worried, oh my God, Army and Navy might have to play twice. It'll ruin the tradition. Don't worry. The green wave of Tulane fixed that for all of you. So, there we are right there. Tulane, 2 losses, a late loss to K-State, and a late loss to Oklahoma, which in most years would be a good thing. Not this year. This is one of the worst Oklahoma teams ever in the past 25 years. So, but there you go. Tulane is still in the hunt for a playoff spot if they win out. Because if They're playing Army for the conference championship. They beat Army, they're gonna jump way up there, in my opinion. And Boise's not guaranteed anything, so you gotta be careful about that. Arizona State at 21. Welcome to the college football playoff race, Arizona State Sun Devils. You are now in the Big 12 conference title race, where if you win that, you'll more than likely get in. Iowa State's kind of still in that race too. They're at number 22. UNLV is ranked. How about that? Good for them. They're 8-2. Looks like they got a win over San Diego State. Illinois is back to being ranked. So I want to check something real quick. Illinois, huh? Did Indiana beat Illinois? I think they did. Or am I thinking of someone else? No, Indiana didn't even play Illinois. Someone played it. I think it was Penn State. So there you go. I was thinking of Penn State. So trying to think. So there you go, Penn State. You have a ranked win, at least in the AP poll. We'll see what happens Tuesday. And welcome. Well, not even welcome. Barely hanging on to a ranked spot. Washington State Wazoo is 8-2 as they lost a late game to New Mexico. How did that happen? How are you still ranked? If you're a Missouri fan, you must be very mad because you're the first team and others receiving votes. But I don't feel bad for Missouri. So there you go. There's your recap of the AP poll that just dropped. That was a little late today. But there we go. We got this cluster of SEC teams. The tiebreakers. It's going to be insane over the next 2 weeks. Again, the final weekend of the regular season is going to be nuts. And it is going to be something to how many teams in the SEC are going to get in this thing. I know at least two from the Big Ten are definitely getting in, possibly three. But the SEC is trying to get like five or six, and who knows what will happen. You need a little bit of chaos, but I think however you feel, like, there's a good chance five SEC teams get in this thing. So just stay tuned and get real. We'll see how things pan out. But everyone who told me the regular season was ruined because of this, it's more interesting than ever now. That's my opinion anyway. So anyway, my team blows and they're going to lose to Alabama this week. But we might have a shot against LSU. Who knows? Because Brian Kelly might lose his job if we beat them. Oh my God, that would be amazing. But anyway, I'll try to be positive. Okay, we'll see if we can try. I'll try to. Maybe we could do something against Alabama. I just don't feel confident. So anyway. Tomorrow I'll be later today or tomorrow I'll be here to talk about the offensive coordinator position, because I know that's a hot topic. But until then, I will catch you all later. Boomer Sooner.